I just want to tell you guys, thank you for allowing me to come this far. Commutation.
An emotional Tondaleo Hall, speaking to the Oklahoma Pardon and Parole Board with a large group of loved ones by her side.
I've really worked hard to be the woman that my children need me to be.
Denied commutation in 2015 and again in 2018. Now.
Commutation is recommended to commute to time served.
A chance at a fresh start.
And normally I just blow it off, don't even want to think about it and get my hopes up, but this time I guess I'll let everybody get my hopes up.
It was back in 2006 when Hall's then boyfriend, Robert Braxton Jr., pleaded guilty to brutally abusing two of her children. Back in 2004, he was sentenced to 10 years in prison with 8 years suspended. He was out in just two. As for Hall, she was also charged and entered a blind plea of guilty to 4 counts of permitting child abuse. Judge Ray Elliott sentencing her to 30 years hard time.
The facts unavailable to the court at that time were the abuse that she suffered from Mr. Braxton. So Mr. Braxton abused Ms. Hall physically, sexually, emotionally.
In a rare letter to the Pardon and Parole Board from current Oklahoma County District Attorney David Prater, he references Hall's 2006 testimony, which was inconsistent with previous statements regarding Braxton's involvement in the abuse of her children. He also mentions another letter, this one written by Hall, sent to Judge Elliott in 2009, where she apologizes for that testimony. Prater ultimately recommending Hall be considered for commutation.
From both Mr. Prater and my knowledge, this is the only time that a district attorney has actively supported a commutation application in Oklahoma.
It changed me a little bit to even hear that.
I wish it had that feeling 10 years ago.
But family members say the mother of three has been resilient, not giving up hope that one day she would be free.
She's ready to be able to come home, see her kids play sports, pick out prom dresses, and, you know, just have a brand new fresh start.